thank you. This next piece is a little angry. Not that angry, just a little angry. I need a vacation. I'm going on very soon. So, but until then, my job's kind of been getting on my nerves, so this is therapeutic. It's called The Company Car. He stands over me, lobster red with too much sun that he clearly got from doing whatever outside task he did this weekend with his two kids and his dog and his wife, the one who once told me at a Christmas party after her fourth glass of wine that she voted for Trump and that everyone is just too politically correct and that she could call me a black woman if she wanted to. Not that the color of my skin should matter in her stories, but clearly it does. Her husband is dangerously close to my side of the desk when he asks me why I haven't done this totally insignificant thing, why I haven't checked off these particular tasks, and all I can think is shut up. You do know that I'm killing it, right? That after 5 years, I've met and exceeded all of my goals every time. Every time, and because my old boss was too lazy to post this position, we ended up with you. You got the job because you asked for it, breaching some human resources policy, no doubt. Lazily, they gave it away to this incompetent imbecile. And here he stands in my office asking me about this. He doesn't want my assistant, doing this because this is part of my job. And then he says with a chuckle in his laugh, well, that's what I'm paying you for. He's wrong because he's not actually paying me. You see, the company is. And too many times he shows up without yelling surprise, visiting my office as if he's trying to catch me doing something unprofessional or perhaps something that would be worthy of termination. Meanwhile, my laptop sits out sunbathing in fluorescent lights until it's jet black. Though freshly closed, it still hums as if it's hooked up to the power cord, and well, there's that mouse too, because I just don't know how to use the touchpad. Out in the open, my laptop tries to blend in with the top of my desk, but sticks out still like the only black person at every meeting I ever go to. And if he opens it, and the screen will reveal the poem and many more, but he doesn't ask about it. Still standing over me, leaning, leering over me, when 6 months ago, his position was beneath mine.